Live from New York, it's Saturday night, and here's your host, the Third Estate.
Yeah. Thank you. Louis. Guys, have you heard you can't even get it up? I mean, how can you call yourself a king if you can't even produce a nair? Don't even get me started on the taxation system. In other words, tax engines for the nobility and clergy than cookies that Louis eats during the day. And Mary's for that. Even in this poor harvest of 1789, the only thing that keeps on growing is her hair. Anyways, we have a great show plan tonight. Marquita Lafayette is in the building. Live from Versailles, Saturday night.
Hi, I'm Peyton Nobility.
And I'm Chloe Parliament.
And this is our son, Louis 16. We hate his current boyfriend, the corrupt taxation system. It's so unjust and unequal.
Sup, I'm the old taxation system.
And we need to change now. We're taking parental control. Here's our date, the Estates General.
Guess he's here.
Hey, I want to replace your boyfriend and fix all the troubles you're having. I want to make the situation better in your country. You need me to legally fix the situation.
Okay, I don't know. I know we need to change, but I don't want to call the Estates General. I met him last in 1614, but it's 1789 right now, and it didn't work out. But the only way I can produce for my country is by choosing the Estates General.
No!
Yes!
In other news, the Estates General has met for the first time since 1614. Says one of the representatives, I didn't know a legislative body existed in France anymore. There was unrest in the Estates General this week. Apparently, the 24 million out of 27 million people in France want some rights. Who knew? I'm not sure, but I think the 24 million people deserve more than one vote in the system. Here to talk about the unfairness is none other than a member of the Third Estate. So, what was your experience like as a bourgeois in the Third Estate?
I wanted votes per head, so that way my friends and family could all have the same and equal say in the government. But to our surprise, Louis and the Parliament of Paris sided with the noble's man.
Bastard.
Unbelievable. So now voting in three separate chambers was the final call. He has no idea who he's messing with.
Interesting. I think something may happen in the estate. National Assembly. Anyway, thanks for your time and good luck.
Thank you.
In other news, it was found that a group of low-level priests broke off of the First Estate and joined the Third Estate. I guess they could identify more with the desire for equality found in the Third Estate.
I was lost and lonely.
I was ready to find love.
I wanted someone who understands me.
I wanted equality in a drafted constitution.
And so did I. When I was feeling down and fed up with the system and the Estates General, priest Jean-Pierre, he was there for me. He made me feel better about myself and came and sat with all the bourgeoisie in the Third Estate.
I couldn't help it. We wanted all the same things, and even if we were separated by class, we weren't so unalike. And now we couldn't be more in love. We together, forever in our National Assembly, will fight for our rights. E-bourgeoisie worked for me. It could work for you too.
Maybe King Louis could have tried that e-bourgeoisie because he clearly needs some harmony with that Third Estate. Back in the news, welcome back to the Weekend Report. After the National Assembly was established, Louis closed the convention under pressure from nobles, saying, Screw these whiny poops from the Third Estate. With nowhere else to go, the Third Estate found a tennis court. There's speculation that the tennis racket can incite revolutionary ideas. Here is a clip of some of our members and from the National Assembly testing it out.
We vow to never disassemble until the new Constitution is born!
And now we have an emergency weather update at the Bastille.
It's July 14th here at Bastille. The storm was so intense that the governor and six soldiers were killed. 98 of the stormers were also killed. They stormed Bastille for supplies and weaponry to protect themselves from the storm. The king had to accept that there was a problem, and he needed to recognize the National Assembly as a new government. Whoa!
Here's our daily hillbilly moment. Enjoy.
Hi, my name is Cecile.
And I'm John Paul.
And we're from the countryside, and this is a hillbilly moment. I'm so scared about those brigands coming and taking all my crops.
You know what we need to do? We need to burn this manor house.
We're gonna burn this manor down!
And now, a special segment from the National Assembly. Wait, excuse me. They've changed their name to the Constituent Assembly because of their latest reforms. Let's take a look at how to dress your constitution.
Good evening, Versailles. I'm your German hunk, talking about the latest French fashions, and I'm here to give you an inside scoop on the latest reforms from August 4th, 1789, until the Constitution of 1791. Here, modeling my latest reforms, are my model, Thomas.
Sorry, Thomas.
First, we have him modeling the abolition of the feudal system with these peasant clothes. Can you say no more? Next, we have the Declaration of Rights of Man with the rule of law and equal citizenship. Don't we all want the taste? That's one buttery croissant. Check out the latest Chevalier laws. Turn, Thomas, turn. Give him a circle. Without trade unions, we can all become as wealthy as Tom A. Pay attention, France. If you know this fashion, you'll be the hippest of all French. If you don't, you'll be part of the tasteless refractory clergy created by the civil conscience of the clergy. The way Thomas nationalizes those church properties just makes me tingle. Ah! What do you think, French clergy? The latest fashion I want to share with you is the Constitution of 1791. Here's representing the Legislative Assembly and the King as the constitutional monarch with these oh-so-fashionable hat. See how it dangles? Merci beaucoup. Vive la France. I hope that you take the latest fashions and cherish them like I cherish this hot bod.
Welcome back. Here's a live news update.
We have just received word that Louis and Mary are trying to escape. They were caught just a little ways away and are now being put under arrest at the Tuileries. This just in.
And now, for our musical guests, singing their hit single, Wake Me Up, When the September Massacres End, Marquis de Lafayette.
Summer 1792 has come and passed. The Paris mobs can never last. Wake me up when September massacres end.
After the Bruins wake manifesto, which threatened French revolutionaries, wake me up when September massacres end.
It's fired up the sans-culottes and added to mob hysteria. Going against the king again, defending the revolution.
Like the bloodshed from the past, counter-revolutionaries killed so fast. Wake me up when September massacres end.
Summer 79 has come and passed. The Paris mobs can never last. Wake me up when September massacres end.
Paris mobs storm the jails, massacring counter-revolutionaries. Wake me up when September massacres end.
Just receiving word of a newfound conflict within the National Assembly. Apparently, two factions, the Girondins and Jacobins, are quarreling over many issues, one of which is what to do with the king.
Hi, today at the convention, we're going to be looking at the fate of King Louis XVI. We have two groups, the Jacobins and the Girondins, and we're going to hear their arguments on whether or not they think King Louis should be executed.
Hi, I'm a Girondin and I'm from the countryside. We believe in a laissez-faire government and we want to preserve Louis's life. This is because we believe that a constitutional monarchy should be preserved and there is no reason for us to take out our monarch.
Hi, I'm Robespierre, and as a member of the upper middle class of Paris, I do not want a strong government and I don't think that we can trust Louis XVI as we've seen in his flight to Varennes and his letter to Leopold.
Everyone in favor of King Louis's execution, please raise your hand. Everyone opposed. In the end, it came down to the votes of 361 to 360 in the favor of Louis's execution. He was killed because of just one vote. Jacobins and Sans-Culottes unite! To the convention!